The World Bank plans to provide $3 to $4 billion U.S. dollars a year to India. Some of the money will go for infrastructure, roads, bridges, power lines. One third of the money will go to help people in India's 7 lagging states, which contain 60% of the country's poor.
One of the things we want to do differently or more of is to be involved in the poorest states in India. So we will continue to be involved in agriculture and irrigation, in working with women's groups and so on. But we want to do more of this in the poorest states. These are not easy places to work, but they're places where there's a lot of need.
The idea is to expand the programs that already work, like a woman's self-help program already active in some states in India. The self-help program provides assistance for issues ranging from nutrition to caring for the handicapped to capital to start small businesses.
Capital will give strength and confidence to the poor, and this project is successful in that area. So through bank linkages, by savings, by giving seed money, the project is able to show the poor a way to reach the capital.
Another focus is public services such as health and education. 44% of India's labor force is illiterate. Bank funding will help cut the number of out-of-school children and boost enrollment among girls and underprivileged groups. Protecting India's scarce groundwater is also a priority.
Water has a linkage with other type of sectors, such as power. If you provide free power for farmers, they will pump water and then they will actually deplete the water. So you want to make sure that you have the right policies so that the farmer use water more effectively, but do not abuse the usage of water.
The plan is to help people in India's poorer states, but also target the poorest in India's middle-income states so as to lift as many people as possible. This comes amidst the global financial crisis, and the government of India has also asked the bank for billions of dollars to help ease the country's credit crunch.